What's the difference between OneDrive and Google Drive and similar services? Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I get variations on this question a lot for the various online storage systems that I think we're all familiar with. Especially after the most recent OneDrive backup feature debacle, which continues to be a debacle as I record this, you might be looking at some of the many alternatives to OneDrive. Which one is best is going to depend on how you use your computer and what your other needs are. The good news is that there are so many to choose from, finding one that works for you, pretty likely. I want to compare some of the top players in the cloud storage game. Now, before I begin, I want to advise you watching this video that it's going to be information dense. I've got a lot of details for each of five different cloud services. You'll find this information also in the article that comes with this video. You'll find that article at askleo.com/174112. You can read along or you can refer to that, but I think it'll be helpful for you to see that article and see the information that I'll be providing. Now, cloud storage and cloud sync. Like I said, there's a lot of cloud storage out there. So to narrow down the field, I'm going to focus only on those providers that also provide synchronization apps for your various devices. More correctly, I'm looking at what I call cloud sync apps. That means you manage what's in your cloud storage primarily by managing what's in a local mirror of that storage on your computer. The sync app then keeps the two in sync, uploading, downloading, and deleting as needed to keep what's on your PC in sync with what's in the cloud. Even in that realm, there are many players. I expect I've overlooked one or more, but here are the five that I'll be looking at. Dropbox, Google Drive, iCloud, OneDrive, and Proton Drive. I'm focusing primarily on those used by individuals and small to medium-sized businesses. If you're looking for larger enterprise solutions, well, that's a whole nother can of worms that I'm not going to try to address here. Each of the five, as I said, has its strengths, its weaknesses, and, of course, some quirks. Dropbox is kind of the granddaddy of synchronization services. While it might not be the first, it's certainly been around for a very long time and is probably the one most people recognize. In its favor, Dropbox is not tied to any particular ecosystem like Apple's or Microsoft's and works equally well in either of them. It's a good collaboration tool, depending on the applications you're using to collaborate. And by collaborate, I typically mean simultaneous editing and revision tracking. Security, robust, includes two-factor authentication as well as physical security key access and more. Data is encrypted when being sent or received, and it's also encrypted while it's stored on the Dropbox servers. Dropbox is known for reliably syncing even with large files, and files and folders can easily be shared with non-Dropbox users. Now, the cons to Dropbox. Dropbox's free tier includes only 2 gigabytes. It's one of the smallest free offerings. Of course, there are plans you can purchase to get more storage. Collaboration can be fragile. Like I said, it works well for some apps, but it might not work as well for others. Server-side data encryption is performed by Dropbox, meaning that even though your data is on their server, they can still decrypt it and see what's inside. Dropbox is a great solution if you're looking for basic, solid cloud storage, and especially if you're using multiple platform families like Windows and Apple. Google Drive. If you have a Google account, you have Google Drive. As you might expect, it works well within the Google ecosystem, such as Google Docs and Sheets and so on. In fact, many of these Google services really work only within Google Drive. The free tier includes 15 gigabytes of space shared between Drive, Gmail, and Photos. Of course, you can buy more. collaboration within the Google ecosystem is almost seamless. Again, data is encrypted while being sent and received, and it's also encrypted on Google's servers. Security is the same security used for your Google account, which can include two-factor authentication, including hardware keys, pass keys, and more. Cons to Google Drive. Syncing has apparently had issues with large files. The breakdown of space used between Gmail, Google Drive, and Photos can sometimes be quite confusing. Now, while not technically a Google Drive issue, Google Docs are not actually stored in that portion of Google Drive synchronized to your computer. They're online only. What shows up on your computer is a reference to the document stored online. And from what I can tell, file sharing appears limited to only other Google account holders. Google Drive's perfect if you are heavy in the Google ecosystem and/or you're doing a lot of collaborative work, again, using Google's tools. iCloud is Apple's entry into the cloud storage space. It's present on every Apple device, and you can install it on Windows as well. It is seamless when using an Apple device. Collaboration works well when using Apple apps like Pages and Numbers and so on. Data is encrypted when being sent or received, and it's also encrypted on Apple's servers. Advanced data protection can be enabled to encrypt the data on Apple's servers in such a way that Apple cannot access it. Only you can. Cons. iCloud is so seamless with Apple devices, you might not even realize that you're already using it. The free tier is only 5 gigabytes, and syncing may be less than reliable on non-Apple devices. If you're in the Apple ecosystem, there's really no question. iCloud is the solution. OneDrive. If you've got Windows version 8.1 or greater, you have OneDrive, whether or not you want it. Apps are available for mobile and Apple platforms as well. OneDrive, of course, is tightly integrated with the Microsoft ecosystem, including Microsoft Office. Collaboration using Office apps is, again, nearly seamless. Data is encrypted when being sent or received, and it's also encrypted on Microsoft's servers. It includes a personal vault, which requires additional sign-in hoops when accessed. Reliable syncing across Windows machines. Additional storage is included if you happen to subscribe to Microsoft 365. And files and folders can easily be shared with non-OneDrive users. Cons to OneDrive. The free tier is only 5 gigabytes, shared with Outlook.com email attachments, which has proven to be exceptionally confusing. Server-side data encryption is performed by Microsoft, meaning that they can decrypt your data, including what's in your personal vault. The so-called backup feature can cause much confusion at best and data loss at worst. OneDrive's great for Windows users with the caveat that you avoid the so-called backup feature. Particularly if you have Microsoft 365, you'll have at least 1 terabyte of storage ready to go. Proton Drive. Offered by the privacy-focused Proton nonprofit, Proton Drive is a relatively new entry into the cloud storage space. Data security and privacy is Proton's reason for existence. Data is encrypted end-to-end, meaning that not even Proton can access your unencrypted data. The syncing app can indeed keep a folder on your machine in sync with your data in the cloud. Files and folders can be shared with non-Proton Drive users, and some plans include an online document editor, think Word Online or Google Docs, email, VPN, and a password manager. Downsides? Collaboration is very limited, if it's available at all, and free accounts include only 5 gigabytes. Proton Drive is great if you already have a Proton account or if you need only basic but very secure cloud storage and synchronization. Now, it's at this point people tend to ask about pricing. What does it all cost? And it is really difficult to do a true apples-to-apples comparison of the pricing on these services, mostly because they have different pricing tiers, different space allocations, different steps from one to the other. It really gets messy. So what I've tried to do is figure out what it would be the cost for an individual to purchase 2 terabytes of storage if they paid annually. Dropbox, it's around $120 a year. A Dropbox Plus plan is the lowest paid plan. Google Drive, about $100 a year, which is a premium Google One subscription. iCloud is around $120 a year, monthly billing only. It's the iCloud Plus plan. OneDrive is around $100 a year. Again, this is part of the confusion now because this is a Microsoft 365 subscription and actually includes up to 6 terabytes of storage, but it's limited to 1 terabyte per account. But you can share these subscriptions to 5 additional accounts. Individual Microsoft 365 subscribers can add 1 terabyte increments for around $120 a year. Proton Drive, around $200 a year. This is a Proton family account, the least expensive, which offers 2 terabyte or more. The actual pricing is around $290 because it actually comes with 3 terabytes, which can, again, be shared with up to 6 other users, and it includes all the other Proton apps. Except for Proton, these services are all really about in the same ballpark, at least as far as I can tell in this comparison. Your choice is going to depend on the specifics of the plans available, your needs, and as those needs compare to the product comparisons above. Okay, so what do? I use them all. It's the nature of what I do for a living. Here's how it breaks down, though. I use Dropbox for lots and lots of basic storage, including all of my photos, collaboration with the nonprofit I support, and yes, I have a paid Dropbox account. I use Google Drive these days mostly because it's there. Gary and I share our TEH podcast working document there. I do not pay for any additional Google storage. I use iCloud, again, mostly because it's there. My wife uses a Mac, and it's a great way to share and back up documents she creates. We do not pay for any extra storage. I use OneDrive for collaboration with my askleo team, as well as storage for askleo in general. It's part of my Microsoft 365 subscription, and I've shared it with additional accounts to make use of additional storage for online backups. I use Proton Drive currently only for online backups. I have what's called a visionary account, which is no longer available, but it includes, again, all of the Proton products. I purchased it originally for email and now use the VPN quite often as well. If I had to pick only one, for me, it would likely be Dropbox, with OneDrive a pretty close second. Cloud storage is super convenient, be it for collaboration or part of, and I have to stress, only a part of a larger backup strategy or a solution providing offsite backup for your important files. You have many options to choose from. And now you've got a sense for what those 5 options are all about. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/174112. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.